creation of the world. When God in the beginning created heaven and earth, and formed man in his own likeness. When century upon century had passed, since the Almighty sent his bow in the clouds after the great flood, as a sign of covenant and peace. In the 21st century, since Abraham, our father in faith, came out of the Ur of the Chaldees. In the 13th century, since the people of Israel were led by Moses in the Exodus from Egypt. Around the 1,000th year since David was anointed king. In the 65th week of the prophecy of Daniel. In the 194th Olympia, in the year 752, since the foundation of the city of Rome, in the 42nd year of the reign of Caesar Octavian Augustus, the whole world being at peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the eternal Father, desiring to consecrate the world by his most loving presence, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and when 9 months had passed since his conception, was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judah, and was made man. The Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the flesh.
Oh, Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we are celebrating the great, good, and joyful news that Jesus Christ is born for us and for our salvation. So, in this, our cathedral, we gather to celebrate that wondrous event when the Son of God took flesh and was born of the Virgin Mary. We come then on this silent night in rejoicing. And at the beginning of this Holy Mass that we celebrate, let us acknowledge indeed that God has been merciful to each one of us. And so, with open and pure hearts, we ask for forgiveness of our sins so that we might more worthily enter into this celebration, into this Eucharist, this great act of thanksgiving. I confess.
Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary,
reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who live in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult with divine plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressors, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Training us to renounce impiety
and worldly passion, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord.
This will be a sign for you.
you will find a child wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. The Gospel of the Lord.
Feel the urgency to share with others the joy of our encounter, the child Jesus, the living Jesus. We must leave the cave of Bethlehem, we must leave the manger, in order to recount to our families, our friends, our communities, the marvel, the stupendous event, the life-changing event. Because to us, to you, is born this day in the city of David, a Savior. A Savior who is Christ the Lord. And remember this, as Pope Francis said in Rome this evening, Jesus did not wait until we were good before he loved us, but gave himself freely to us. May we not wait for our neighbors to be good before we do good to them, for the church to be perfect before we love her, for others to respect us before we serve them. With the shepherds, let us at least figuratively run to meet that child who has changed the course of history and the course of each of our lives. In him, God has first come to meet us. He has shown us his face, full of grace and tenderness and mercy. And now, in this Eucharist, he once again shows us his tenderness as he gives himself to us, so that the life that he has, he shares with us, and he wants us to have that life in abundance.
Jesus, the Word of God made flesh, will be God's joy for all members of the church. We pray to the Lord. That Jesus, the Prince of Peace, will be God's peace among nations and groups of people. We pray to the Lord. That Jesus, consolation of every human heart, will be God's healing and inner strength for families in need. We pray to the Lord. That Jesus, the Savior of the world, will be God's light to those in despair. We pray to the Lord. In the quiet moment, we think of the intentions in our heart. We pray to the Lord. That Jesus, King of glory, will be God's everlasting happiness for those who have died. We pray to the Lord. We pray now the prayer for reverence for life. Almighty God, giver of all that is good, we thank you for the precious gift of human life, for life in the world coming from your creative power, for life in children making us glad for their precious promise, for the life in young people hoping for a better world, for life in people who are disabled, teaching us that every life has value, for the life of the elderly, witnessing to the ages values of patience and wisdom. Like Blessed Mary, may we always say yes to your gift. May we defend it and promote it from conception to its natural end, and bring us at last, O Father, to the fullness of eternal life. Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord God, the Blessed
a second collection after Holy Communion to support the outreach work of the cathedral. Thank you for your prayers and support.
Thank you. that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Thank you.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who hold him to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise for the offering for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred night on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth the Savior for this world, and in communion with those whose memories we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that your whole family order our days through peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread and his holy in their own hands, and with eyes raised in heaven to you, O God, his Almighty Father, giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks,
he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment by your presence. For us also, your servants, to those sinners who in your abundant mercies graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Basilius, Peter, Elizabeth, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us to beseech you in their company, not with our merits, but grant us your heart, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
time we will have Holy Communion. For those of you who are Catholic, practicing, and prepared to do so, you may come forward to receive Holy Communion. For those of you who are not Catholic, not prepared to receive Holy Communion, or simply not ready, please you may come forward to receive a blessing. To receive a blessing, please cross your arms over your chest, and this will indicate to the priest that you would like to receive a blessing. Alternatively, if you don't want to receive communion, you may stay in the pews and use this time for your own prayers and thoughts.
When our need for a Savior was great, and you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary, to our lives he brings joy and peace, justice, mercy, and love. Remind us of the humble birth of Jesus, and raise up our thoughts to him who is God with us and Savior of all, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
May Christ, our God, enlighten your hearts and minds, now and forever.
Amen.
I didn't know that.
Et stella